We're going to press. We just call it the press. Because how would you press without the shoulders? You know, so we just call it a press. You can leg press, but that's gay, so we just call it a press. I want to show you a couple of salient points about this thing. First off, I want you to take a grip that's going to be slightly outside your shoulder width so that your thumb is able to be right up against you like this when you have the bar on your shoulders. Now, if I look from either the front or back, I can see that your forearms are essentially vertical. I want your forearms vertical because we're going to press straight up, and I want the force to come up in a straight line and into the bar, because if you're out too wide, then there gets to be a little moment arm between here and your elbow. Okay, so we want everything vertical. We also want everything vertical when we look at it from the side, and that's going to require that you hold your elbows in front of the bar like that. Okay, we've got to make up the lateral distance between the front of the chest and the back here, back where the shoulder blade is, right? And that's a distance of about 6 inches. We're going to do that with torso movement. So what you're going to do is you're going to lean slightly back. You're going to push the bar up just as close to your face as you can get it. And then what you're going to do is you're going to move under the bar by moving your torso forward. It'll look like that, okay? Elbows up, chest up, big breath. Drive it up. Squeeze. Now, I don't want you to be in an exaggerated lordotic curve here, because that's not good for spinal discs, okay? Everything needs to be in normal anatomical position, okay? Don't exaggerate anything, okay? That's not necessary. Tighten all this up. Tighten up abs, and that'll pull this into the correct. See, in order to get real hyperextended in your lumbar spine, you almost have to relax here. So tighten this up, and that'll take that out. Now, let's make sure that you're fully engaged with your traps, because your traps hold up your shoulder blades. So let's squeeze up and shrug, because the shrug active is what holds the traps up. Traps are what hold the shoulder blades up, and the shrug activates the traps. This is the full lockout position, just like this. And if I'm teaching him, I'm going to pull up against the upper arm here, and at the same time, just gently suggest to him that his elbows need to be more locked out, if in fact they're not already. Drive. Okay. We need a vertical line on the bar path. I don't want you to move it out around your face. I want you to aim for your nose. Okay? Just like that. Much nicer. Two. See how close you can get to your nose. You'll only hit it once. That was the best one.